My notes used to look like this, but now they look like this. Continue watching to find out how. Hey everyone, my name is Hazal and I'm a UK-based medical student. I run this channel with my best friend Liddy and we use it to document our lives to becoming doctors as well as sharing student tips. By the end of this video, you'll know the exact method I use to make notes that are aesthetic, concise and easy to understand. So let's jump straight into the video with step one, which is setup. Of course, the first thing I do is grab my iPad Pro and Apple Pencil. I then open up a new page on Notability and add in the lecture title and number. The specific lecture I'll be making notes on today is called Cranial Nerves, which is lecture number 8. I also make sure I'm using grid paper as this ensures my notes are neat and organized, but to be honest, this is a personal preference and you can use any type of paper, including plain, lines and dotted. Now thinking about it, I probably use grid paper because it helps me feel more connected to maths, which used to be one of my favorite subjects. But anyway, let's get on to step two, which is main title. Then I go on to make my main title for the lecture, which, depending on how creative I'm trying to be, can take some time. To do this, I use a mixture of the pen tools and the highlighter tools to create a nice looking title. I'm not going to lie to you guys, you can definitely skip this step and I could just scribble on a title and get on to note taking, but I find that writing a cool title makes my notes come together in a more nice way and also makes the whole process more fun for me, so make sure you try it out and see what works for you. Step number three is split. Once my main title is done, I split my page into three straight columns. Guys, this has helped me massively in ensuring my notes are neat and organized instead of all over the place. The columns help me have a good structure with my notes and honestly, it is a lifesaver. During first year, I used to make my notes in a messy order and there were no columns and no real structure and it was so bad. Imagine it's exam season and you have to revise from a big fat blob of text. No one wants that. However, having the columns makes everything so much more easier to read and understand. Step number four, open your lecture. Of course, if we are making notes, we need some sort of information to make these notes from, whether that be a textbook, lecture recording, or even lecture slides. I mainly use lecture slides and I either have my lecture slides up on another device like my laptop, or I'll split my iPad screen and have my notes on one side and my lecture slides on another side. For this video, I'll be splitting my iPad screen, which you do by swiping right on Notability and selecting the lecture slides you'd like to see. Step number five is to start writing. Now that I'm finally set up and ready to go, it's time to start making my notes. So I start scrolling through my lecture slides and find the first topic I would like to make notes on. In my lecture, the first topic is an overview of cranial nerves. So I start by writing overview at the top of column one using a thick pen tool. I then start making notes on the key information for this topic using a thin pen tool. I use the different thickness pens as it helps me fit more notes onto one page and it also helps my title stand out. I write my notes in a bullet points format rather than in full sentences, as this helps me summarize the information, making it more easy to understand. Whilst writing my notes, I try to summarize the information into my own words, as this makes the whole note-taking process more active rather than me copying down what I see on the slides, which is quite passive. Sometimes I need to add more information to my notes, which I do use in a different color pen like red. Step number six is to continue writing. When I'm done with the first topic, I cut off the lines of the columns to box off that section and repeat the whole process for the next topic. Again, this helps ensure my notes are in easy, manageable sections rather than long streams of text that I can't even be bothered to look at, let alone read. I also add images from my lecture slides to my notes to have that visual aid and help with my learning. I then continue with this whole process until I am done making my notes. Step number seven is to highlight. When I am finally done making my notes, I go back to the start of my notes and highlight all the key information. The reason I do all my highlighting at the end is because it forces me to reread my notes and make sure that I really understand it. This is another way I make sure my note-taking process is more active than passive. When I am finally done highlighting, I zoom out to admire my beautiful notes. If I want, I can also use the Notability multi-notes view feature to admire two notes at once. If you want to know about all the other Notability features you can use to make your notes that bit better, make sure to check out this video where I go over every single Notability feature. I hope you all enjoyed this video and I'll see you all in a new video next time. Bye!